Now in this section we are going to see about the derivation of axial electric field in traveling wave tube. So this is a part 4 lecture of the traveling wave tube. First part we have seen about the concept or the working principle of traveling wave tube and its operation. Second lecture we have seen about the significance of slow wave structures and amplification process taking place in traveling wave tube. Third part we have seen about the convection current in the traveling wave tube, and now the fourth part we are going to learn about the concept of this axial electric field or the derivation of axial electric field occurring in traveling wave tube. Now speaking on about the axial electric field, we know how is a electric field produced in the traveling wave tube. That is, once the RF input which we are applying to this helical slow wave structure is going to pass through it, it produces an electric field which is axial in nature. So that is the first point. RF input traveling in helical slow wave structure produces an axial electric field. So always the direction we are assuming it to be in the positive z direction, and this is the electron beam. So obviously there will be interaction between these electron beam and the axial electric field. That is the second point. Once the electron enters into the axial electric field, then there will be interaction between the electron beam and the axial electric field. We know axial electric field is produced by this RF input. Okay, so here once the electron beam enters this axial electric field, electron beam and RF will interact and there will be exchange of energy, and that is how the amplification of signal take place, which we have already seen. Now coming to learn about the axial electric field, we consider our helical slow wave structure to be a distributed lossless transmission line. So this is the third point. Helical slow wave structure is considered now as a distributed lossless transmission line. Now we have told that we are going to represent our helical slow wave structure by a distributed lossless transmission line. So the equivalent circuit of our helical wave structure can be represented by a transmission line as such. So it is now going to be replaced by inductors and capacitance as shown. So we are having capacitor, inductor and so on. So this is our equivalent circuit. That is, a slow wave helix is now represented by a distributed lossless transmission line. So this is our helical structure and this is a representation of electron beam. Okay, so we are going to represent our electron beam by this particular lines. So this convection current which is associated with our electron beam is now represented by the small letter I. And the current which is existing in the transmission line, that is our helical structure, is now being represented by the capital I. So this is a small I associated with the electron beam and capital I is associated with the transmission line. So we'll assume a small portion, that is dz. We know that is we are assuming the direction of propagation in the positive z. So we take now a small section, say dz, and the voltage which is existing in this particular portion to be capital V. So after this particular section of dz, now the voltage is now written as V, initial voltage, plus dou V by dou z into dz. So writing these parameter of the voltage and current is important. Similarly, we assume that initial current to be capital I in the transmission line. After a portion of dz, we now represent the current to be capital I plus dou I by dou z into dz. Now the convection current which is associated with the electron beam is represented as I, and after passing through the structure it becomes I plus dou I by dou z into dz. Now the parameters here are explained as shown. L is the inductance per unit length, C is the capacitance per unit length, capital I is the alternating current in the transmission line, capital V is the alternating voltage in transmission line, and small I is the convection current associated with the electron beam. Now we are going to consider this particular equivalent helical structure. We have considered it as a distributed lossless transmission line and the representation of electron beam as such. Now we are going to consider a small section. Okay, this particular DZ section in the equivalent helical structure. So now we are going to consider only this particular small section, say DZ. Initially a voltage V is being developed here. Now here we have to also understand one more thing, that is a current of say minus dou I by dou Z into DZ is now injected from the electron beam into the transmission line. So that is important. So writing this voltage and the current equations are important, both of the electron beam and this circuit. At the same time, we have to remember, because of the convection current in the electron beam, a current of minus dou I by dou Z into dz is induced from the electron beam into the transmission line, that is indicated here by this particular arrow. So that is this point which is important. Now what we go to do is that we consider a small section here, say for example this particular section, and then we are going to apply the KCL and KVL laws. That is, since it is a circuit, we can apply the KCL and KVL laws. So application of the transmission line theory and KCL to the electron beam results in, so when we apply the KCL to this particular structure or to this particular section, then we get what? Dou I by dou Z is equal to minus of C into dou V by dou T. We are all familiarized with this particular equation. But in addition, here a extra current, that is a current injected from the electron beam to the transmission line, should also be considered. So minus of dou I by dou Z should also be considered. It is getting injected into this particular portion of say DZ. So the current is minus dou I by dou Z. So this is our first equation. Now we can replace this. Okay, dou by dou Z can be replaced by minus gamma, and dou by dou T can be replaced by j omega, and then we get the second equation. Okay, these are the basic concepts from the electromagnetics by which this is replaced. I will explain in my next slide in a better manner to understand how this replacement is being done. That is in the first equation. Now how in the previous step we have replaced dou by dou Z as minus gamma and dou by dou T as j omega, the steps are written for understanding in a better manner. That is, we know we have a wave which is propagating in positive Z direction. So the propagation constant is indicated by minus of gamma. So the voltage can be written as Ve raised to j omega t minus of gamma Z, we have expressed in the phasor form, and then further carried out dou V by dou Z and dou V by dou T. That is how we have got dou by dou Z as minus gamma and dou by dou T as j omega. So we have replaced as such. Now we can apply the KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, to this particular section. So we are having to write the equation for this particular section, and applying the KVL we get dou V by dou Z, that is the voltage V which is developed, can be written as minus of L dou I by dou T, where capital I is the current which is in the transmission line. Okay, so again we can make the replacement, that is instead of dou by dou Z we can write it as minus gamma, and instead of dou by dou T we can write it as j omega, and then we get the equation for the expression of current I in the transmission line. So we can substitute this third equation obtained in the second equation, that is, this was our second equation obtained. So when I am substituting the value of I in the second equation, I get as such. So we get an expression as such. Now in the next step we are going to see about the conditions of when the convection current is zero and when the convection current is not zero. That is, this small I represents our convection current The capital I is the current in the transmission line and small I is the convection current due to electron beam. So this small I, in the next step we will see what will happen if it is zero and what will happen if it is not zero. Now in this particular equation, as I told, you will see what happened when the convection current small I is equal to zero. If I is equal to zero, this term will vanish and only these two terms remain in which voltage V is common. So we get the propagation constant gamma to be equal to j omega root of LC. Now we know this value, it is a propagation constant for an ideal transmission line. So we can represent it as gamma naught. Okay, so gamma naught square, how can we write? Minus omega square LC. Okay, this is our fifth equation. Now we'll see what happened to this equation when the convection current I is not zero. When the convection current I is not zero, we get the voltage equation as such. I have represented it to be the sixth equation. Now we'll make a slight modification in this equation. That is, we know the characteristic impedance for a transmission line, distributed lossless transmission line, is given by root of L by C. Since we have represented our circuit, okay, with the lossless transmission line, we can consider it the characteristic impedance of a distributed transmission line as Z0 is equal to root of L by C. And also we know the value of gamma naught as j omega into root of LC. Now when I multiply this Z0 and gamma naught, Z0 into gamma naught, it leads to j omega L. So this j omega L, in this particular equation, you can see in this particular equation, now I am going to replace this j omega L with Z0 into gamma naught. So when I am making such a substitution, I get the equation as such. Gamma square V is equal to gamma naught squared V minus gamma gamma naught Z0 I. That is, to this particular equation, when the convection current I is not zero, instead of j omega L, I have replaced it by Z0 into gamma naught. That is what is done. So now continuing, we get the expression for V. We have made a replacement and finally we have obtained a equation for the value for V. Now what is our intention? We are writing about the axial electric field. We need to know what is the amplitude of our axial electric field in the structure. So we have a standard relation for connecting our electric field E and the V. That is, EZ can be written as minus of del into V. Now since we are considering only the Z component, we can write the del to be dou by dou Z of V. So del V can be written as dou by dou Z of V, since we are considering only the Z here. Now from the previous substitution, we know that dou by dou Z is minus gamma. So minus and minus goes, it becomes gamma into V. Okay, so EZ is now becoming gamma into V. So how can we write the EZ now? We know the expression for V, we have found out. So multiplying gamma to this equation, we get the amplitude of the axial electric field, which is our final equation. So for this equation, I'll multiply with gamma and get the expression for axial electric field as such. Now this equation is an important equation. It is called as the circuit equation because it is going to determine how the axial electric field here, capital E1, of the slow wave helix is affected by the spatial AC electron beam current, that is the small I. So how the axial electric field E1 is affected by the AC electron beam current I is given by this particular circuit equation. So this equation is also referred to as the circuit equation. So in this section, we have seen the derivation of the amplitude of the axial electric field in the slow wave structure.